Hello and welcome. We are doing a Link to the Past randomizer today. Although, in keeping with the Metroid theme that I've been going with recently, we are doing the Metroid Prime sound pack. So, hopefully, y'all like the Metroid Prime music. So, I play with the fox sprite. I always just make the name Kitsune, which is the Japanese word for fox. So it'll be 7-7 defeat Ganon, but I like playing Keysanity, so all the keys for all the dungeons are shuffled, and I have to beat all the crystal dungeons and go through Ganon's tower, defeat Agahnim 2, and then beat Ganon himself. So without further ado, let's get started. 3, 2, 1, and hold up. Go. So, I apologize if I'm a bit rusty, but I haven't done one of these in several months. Tier 1 drop is 80 bucks. I will take that. Kakariko has a lot of checks, and with bombs I can make pretty much all of them. So I usually tend in like a regular run, ooh, that's nice, to just start here. And then, depending on what items I get, I'll go different places. If I have a good, healthy supply of bombs, I'll do South Shore. So, we'll... Oh, I'm just gonna go open up the bomb shack. Or the item shack, because you get more than bombs in there. But do that so I can stock up on bombs while I'm here, and go from there. Because especially if I don't have a weapon for a mini Moldorm cave, okay. I'm getting a bunch of bombs. I'll probably open that shack up anyway, just to have a way to top off once I'm done here. But I don't like doing mini Moldorm cave with just bombs, because they like to juke me a bit too much. I'll go ahead and do that. This is probably my second favorite music pack, and that is second only to the Golden Sun music pack, just because I spent so many hours on Golden Sun and The Lost Age when I was a kid, and since I've been older. Let's see. Yeah. I should have just gone for it, but nah. But yeah, so the next one I do will probably be the Golden Sun MSU. It's just really good. The vast majority of the picks are very well done thematically. Like Tundaria Tower for Ice Palace as an example. My only complaint about it is that the Dark Overworld music should be different before you get all the crystals. Dang it. Sorry, I'm not used to how I save and quit. Okay, so we'll do South Shore. And then if we don't find anything down here, we'll do Eastern Area. I also sometimes play with palette shuffle, but I wanted the first one to be just regular colors. The only thing I have changed besides the sprite is the heart beeping sound is slowed down, so it's a little less harsh on the ears. Also, please let me know in the comments if game volume is good compared to voice volume, or if I need to crank up the game volume a little bit. Oh, nice. Yo, they were nice to me today. Go figure. Does that mean I should just complain about everything and it'll be nice to me? I'm also just realizing that I'm dumb and I could have gone back and checked back of escape since I have the power glove. But I want to go ahead and finish the Hylia checks just because the ice rod cave is so far out of the way. I'll probably also just go ahead and check Hobo. I almost have enough money to do Zora. So I might actually go do that as well. Oh, nice. Love me some blue potion. Now, you might be asking yourself, you know, why am I not saving and quitting if I'm going to be going over to Back of Escape and Zora area and all that? Well, the randomizer uses the 1.0, the Japanese 1.0 version of the game, which has a few tricks in it that are not present in any other version. One of which is called fake flippers. So there are other ways to do it, but commonly you'll see people do that where you jump in one pixel away from the screen transition, and that gives you time to swim to the next screen before it checks to see whether you have flippers, so it will not boot you out of the water if you do it correctly. The only downside is that if you get hit, in the original game, it's a soft lock. Here, I think it just resets you to the last place you were at when you jumped in. I think at some point it may have also killed you. I don't know if that was this or not. But either way, as long as I don't get hit, I should be fine. Just gonna move over here to quote-unquote safety, and there we go. I was gonna farm money from that thing. Whoops. Ow. I forgot I was going to farm money from that rock over by Ice Rod Cave, so... Oh well. At this point, it is just faster to save and quit over to Back of Escape, so we'll do that. And then you can talk to either the priest or Zelda to refill your health, which is always a nice touch. I could always check Agahnim's cave at this point. I think I'm gonna go check Sahasrara, because that's three checks there. I could dip Eastern. I can't do much in there, but I could at least go in and take a look-see. I also forgot that the tier 1 drop is 80 bucks, but it's kind of hard to do that with nothing to do damage other than bombs. Womp is green then. Also, really? That didn't reach? There's our damage. I haven't been able to get that room right in so long. There's a way you can walk into this room where only two of the stealth posts spawn, but I haven't been able to nail it for a long time. Generally I get three, but that time I goofed it and got four, so. This last check is technically out of logic because I don't have lamp, but it's not that difficult. This kind of sucks when you don't have a sword to hold out in front of you to kill the small enemies. These are health refills, yeah? Okay. Yeah, that was a whole lot of nothing, but getting hammer is nice. Let's go back and check Zora. I only take that heart refill for the stinking crabs. because those things hurt a lot for this early in the game. I also don't know which trees are pull trees. Other than two, so the fact that I know that I can get, you know, 80 rupees for killing one enemy without taking damage is not terribly useful outside of, like, two spots. But that's also just something I've never really known. Important check. I'm glad I did that. I can check all the way up to Zelda without Lamp, logically, so I'm gonna do that. And I also need to check Sick Kid because I have a bottle now. That's nice. At this point, I've got, like, Sick Kid and Nagina, so I'll go check those two things. There we go. So about Agena, I'll check that later. Now that I have Dark World access, that's what I need to be going for. There's quite a few things I can check right around here. Oh, wow. That's convenient. It's unusual to know which dungeons, all of the crystal and pendant dungeons this early, so that's nice. And then, just for good measure, I'm going to come up here and check which ones are the good crystals. Mire and Hera. There we go, sword at 25, almost 26 minutes. Only minor issue I have right now is that, while I have a way into the Dark World, I don't have a way out, so there's gonna be a lot of ow. There's gonna be a lot of ow. There's gonna be a lot of saving and quitting. I only have 3 smalls and no big key. So I don't really want to go in there yet. Okay. I mean, at this point, I'll take it. I'll try to make it to Catfish, but I have a feeling I'm going to get hit on my way up there. That's not health. And I really don't, I'm not going to waste my blue potion on this. I also had completely forgotten that I had a sword, so that would have been a lot smarter. Thank you. See, was this worth it? Not at all. I mean, having more health is nice. Especially because at this point, the only dungeon I can complete is Thieves Town, and that's kind of where I'm gonna have to go. But. And, I mean, without the small key, I only miss one check, so it's not that big of a deal, but... Feels nice. That's nice. Doesn't help protect me from the fireballs, but that will make blind a little bit safer. Boots would also be nice. Ow. That's also nice. Not what I meant to do. Dang it. Air smells nice. I know I could get money for Dig Game over at the Arrow game there, but I am not good enough at that to win the big bucks from it, so, ooh! I guess I go dip Skull Woods then. And check a couple of things in there. I have to go back around. I'm also gonna check Lumberjack item to see if I need to beat Aga 1. First item in there is also on the table now, so to keep that in mind. Excuse me? There we go. I'll do it once more. Oh, whoops. I'm gonna check what the crab did. Okay. Cool, cool. Don't need to do that. At least not all the way through. I'm just gonna go check Agina's cave since I'm thinking about it, and it's... I know it's out of the way, but... Have you got, like, this dig game? The chest at the front of Skull Woods that I should have checked first? And... First check in... Aga Tower. And then if, like, I'm thinking if none of those have anything, then I'd probably just have to go bite the bullet and go into pod with only three smalls. Because with four small keys, I can, well, that's a good point, it's a pendant dungeon, so I might not even have to clear it. Also, Agena has like one of, I think, three or four randomized lines. Let's see which one we get today. Yes, best line there is. Once I farted in this cave so bad all the jazz hands guys ran away and hid in the sand. Let's go ahead and just go into pod. Thankfully, I can check all the bow lock stuff in here, too. Which makes it more of a valuable play. Alright, that one doesn't move. Ooh, that's good. I can do desert. Well, I can do the front of desert. I can't full clear it. Because no big key. Thank you. I can finish Skull Woods now. Except I need one key. Actually, what am I talking about? I know exactly what small key I can steal to complete that. So let's go do that, because that is one of my required dungeons. At least I'm facing Moth with Tempered Sword. That'll make my life easier, and I have blue cane and blue potion, so should be pretty safe. And I can go up, I can snag two items in there as well. Well, three. Only thing I can't get out of there is the big key item. Big chest. And because I have red cane, I can cheese this next room, which is nice, because, I mean, I'm fine. I have equipment, I have health, but it's just so much better to cheese this room. Take me away! So yeah, another thing about version 1.0 is that you can get grabbed or hit while you're doing a fall, so that's to make sure I don't get grabbed while I'm falling into the boss room. And fun fact, if you hit Moth into the spikes, he does not take damage, so I'm waiting for him to get there or there. So with book, I'm gonna go do desert. With this MSU pack, Desert has one of my favorite tracks in it, so looking forward to that. Every time. Now. Speaking of the jazz hands, guys. Ooh, yes. This is the play. Oh, this is the play. Now, if only I could find boots. So we could actually go fast. Oh. Saved it. Then after we activate the flute, I'm gonna go grab the first item in Aga Tower and go from there, depending on what that is, if it's nothing or if it's useful. Thank you. Oh, and I finally have Death Mountain access. That is my next stop, absolutely. 100%. And I don't know why the tracker for this has that little line on the left side, so I apologize if that's annoying to look at. I don't know how to fix that. But at the very least, the background is dark and not gray like how the Fusion Rando tracker was when I first started that. So either a hookshot or a mirror would be really nice here so I can check the other side of the mountain. I got neither of those things. Well, there is one other thing I can check here.
Thank you.
Nice vanilla item. So, go get the blacksmith and save and quit. Turn him in, get the chest, save and quit, go open that. This reminds me of one of my earliest randomizer seeds for this game, where my freaking mirror was in Ganon's tower. That was real fun. I had another one similar, but with the flute being there instead of mirror. And I've also had boots and GT before, so what are you gonna do? Without boots, I think it's faster just to warp again. Then after this, I'll check Meyer's shed. Because I can open up Meyer, but I can't do anything in there without either hookshot or boots. There we go. Can't do a ton in Hera without the big key. I can check basement. I can check two items in, well, three items in there. And I can do... I'm just going to do right side of the mountain first. And then go unlock Turtle Rock. If I can. And do Upper Dark Death Mountain. Because Lower Dark Death Mountain is done. flashing lights warning, potentially. I don't remember if I had it set to reduce flashing or not. I did not, so it's safe to look back. It's also kind of annoying not having a boomerang either. Take this as a water break. Remember, always stay hydrated. Say I have to fix that, don't I? Yep. Oh wait. Kind of sort of forgot about that. Don't really need that. Funny enough, I can actually check a few things in Turtle Rock, so I might do that. If I can open it. Because if I need Bombos, I'm locked, but... Oh, it is Aether for both. Okay, well, flashing lights warning again. I can check 1, 2, 3, 4 things in here. So hard to not to whistle along with this, but I don't want to like murder anybody's ears by accident. Okay. That works. Well. Few rooms in this game bring fear into the hearts of men. This next room is one of them. The Chain Chomp room is awful. as you can see there. That is not, it's not the worst room in the game, but boy is it up there. Are you kidding me? That's so not worth it. I got two more checks I can do in here. Ooh, yes, please. I'm not navigating the Samaria room without a lamp. Almost said without a light source. Technically I have a light source, just not for that. Thank you. Oh, I thought I had my boomerang on for a second. So if this is another Japanese 1.0 exclusive thing where if you're in a cave and you hit the mirror as you're pushing a block, it will delete the block. But it only works in caves. It does not work in dungeons. Because in dungeons it'll just spit you back out at the entrance. And big key of deserts. And that's where I'm gonna go. Thank you. I also think I'm gonna make the tracker smaller next time. I don't know why I made it so big. I'm gonna go check the Bombos tablet and I believe it's K-45, which is over by South Kakariko. Both of which are mirror locked, which is why I couldn't check them before. Might have to check Hillwood's big chest. This rate, because having those keys is kind of pointing me in that direction. Having more pod smalls doesn't do much for me without a light source, because I don't want to navigate that maze by darkness. I'd much rather do that in the light, because I don't have it memorized, and those Kadongos hurt. There we go! I'm gonna make a boots check real quick, and then it's Meyer time. Finally, an hour and a half in, we can go fast. Actually, I'll do a couple checks here first. Because we got the graveyard ledge check, which is also mirror locked. And I also want to go see if the cape check is anything necessary. Oh. There we go. That's for those who don't know, that's another Japanese 1.0 exclusive glitch called Spin Speed, where if you're on a set of stairs like that and you charge a spin attack, release it, and then press your dash button on, I believe it's on the next frame, then you get run speed while you walk. The main downside is that you can't use items or weapons until basically you get hit. Another way to do it, which I'll show later, is you can do something called item dashing, where you hit the dash and item button at the same time. And if you do that with a hookshot on stairs like that, it will also grant spin speed. But it does have to be on the same frame, so it's not terribly difficult, but it's not easy either, I don't think. It's not like the easiest trick in the game. Hey, okay. So I can actually go do Meyer. I forgot I didn't have the... Ow. Big key. Ow. I think with one small key, I can full clear it, question mark? Should be able to full clear it. Because it's not, like, drop sanity as well. Then I can check King's Tomb, and then it is off to Mire. Another flashing lights warning. I'll have to double check that setting next time to make sure I have it set to reduce flashing. I really don't want to be the reason that somebody has a seizure. I would feel awful. And then if you don't have hookshot, you can just bonk off that rock there. Technically can beat this dungeon. I forgot I need a lamp downstairs. I really hope the game is nice and gives me a light source, because really do not want to do this dungeon. I really don't want to do this dungeon in pieces parts. Got my ice smalls, even though I don't technically need both of those, because I can just skip half the dungeon. Need that big key, though. I got all four bottles. Then, I don't know if this is a Japanese 1.0 exclusive, but, you can do this room faster by doing that. trying to think of where the lamp might be at this point. Where's my hookshot? If I don't find the lamp in this last check, I'm gonna go do a hookshot cave. See if it's in there. Because I'm not familiar enough with the downstairs of this dungeon to do it in the dark. So that's unfortunate, but I got the hookshot, and that's a big step forward. My favorite thing that I learned about the hookshot watching both randomizers and speedruns of this game is can't take damage. So this gives me an extra 4 item checks. And unfortunately, this is probably if I find the lamp, the flippers. Or the Hera big key, that means that that dip into mire was required. There it is. So that means my hobo check is in logic, and now I can go check Waterfall Fairy, see if I can get more potions. If not, I'll just buy some, because I always want a couple extra in ice. Mostly for magic, in case I goof something up. I also don't remember if the flipper locked item in Zora was anything important. Okay. Bees! If it's a key, I'm gonna get it. If it's not, then I'm not gonna worry about it. Nope. Okay. Just the vanilla item. Inside where you get the health refill. Mm-hmm. And because I have red cane, it means I can do a fun little trick here called Icebreaker. And just like that, I'm through the railing and I skip half the dungeon. Pod big. So the way to do that is you go from the door, you go all the way straight right, move one frame to the left, place your Samaria block, or no, yeah, no, so, all the way to the right, move one frame to the left, then hit down, hold down right if you're not moving, kind of like how I was just kind of walking in place. You'll know you've hit the correct spot. Lay your Samaria block. Move one frame to the left, and then down and right again, and you're through the block. I believe it's down and right afterward. I've already forgotten what my movement was for that. But there are tutorial videos out there that explain that better than I do. I don't have the big key. That's kind of important. I guess I checked the Thieves' Town thing. Because Pod Big doesn't do a whole lot for me without the lamp. Feels like this is Aladdin. Give me the lamp! Got it. That dash is pixel perfect, by the way. I'm honestly surprised I nailed it first try. Because I usually don't get the positioning correct. we take those. We definitely take those. Ah, Skullwood's big. That's the other thing I was gonna check in that spot. Right. Just a couple of big keys would set me up. Ice big, Hera big. Eastern big. And then a lamp. And then that's go mode. Thank you. I can go beat Meyer. And the remainder of pods on the table. I have the big key, so if necessary, I will go clean out pod after this. What? Dang it. Forgot that still wasn't safe. I guess, sorry, flashing lights warning for this boss. There is a bomb jump to get to the ledge with the hammer chest. I don't know how to do it, so I will be doing this. Plus, you know, I don't need to worry about the key, so I'm just gonna do this the old-fashioned way. There's one of my big keys. Okay. Apparently there's one other thing I didn't check in here. I'm trying to think of what it would be. Oh, I didn't check this item. Huh. So powder and shovel open up two checks. Dang it. Before I do another one of these, I have to go back and watch what the movement is for that. I think I'm going too far over. I don't like that I'm finding all these one-off check items, because some of them are... none of them are very close to each other. I'm also hoping that I can manage the quick kill here, because... no. That makes life, god dang it, a whole lot easier. Thank you. Ah. It's too far to the right. Almost at it. There's my ice big. And I just need Hera big and I'm solid. So I'm gonna do all those one-off checks real quick. Just to get them out of the way. So I will be on my merry way to Ice Palace then. And unfortunately, there are also four more items in the back of Turtle Rock that I can access. I'm hoping that it's just in either the big chest or at Cold Stair, because I don't want to go back into Turtle Rock. It's just a slog, you know? It just takes a while to get there. Okay, so it's you press down to get through the barrier. That's it.
Wait.
Since I have full health, there's also another trick I can do where I hit the boss with the sword beam while the flame is still on it, and it acts as a second flame. Because the fire rod does more damage than the sword does. That wasn't too bad. Total Rock, here I come. Again. Dang it. I don't have the GT big either, that's also concerning. I'm gonna do a couple of quick checks over here first. There's one item back here, and then there's one in the tower, the other chest in the tower that I can get. And then beyond that, I think it's just Turtle Rock again. Which, of course, if I find the fourth small, I can beat it. I just hope that my last big key isn't on pedestal or something stupid. Because then that would mean finding the swamp small, and then going through and beating that dungeon. I mean, I have everything I need, I just, except for the Harabig. What am I doing? It's not the correct door. This is the correct door. I just want to make sure that GT Big isn't back here.
Thank you.
That's good, especially if I have to do Armos Knights. So if you're in cape, under the cape, and you hold on to the wall, it won't drain your magic, at least in this room. I don't know how universal that is. I just know that it won't do that in here, so it's an easy way to cheese the room. I had a feeling. My guess is that it's at the, could be at the, Pyramid Ferry. That's my guess. Pyramid Ferry, unfortunately for me, Turtle Rock boss is also an option now. I think I have an idea of where it is. So I think this small key up here is the small key that's up here in desert is the swamp small. And I think the GT big is in swamp. This is a GT small, then it's not in swamp. Unless the Turtle Rock boss item is swamp small. No enemies. Oh, it's the other Skullwood's key. Okay. I'm running low on checks. I think it's on Trinex. The title of this video is going to be. Thank you. Okay, I didn't think that was a thing. Yeah, I can never get that dash right. Oh my god. Oh, that is cursed. That is so damn cursed. Granted, I mean, we get to hear the best music in the game, at least, but good lordy loo. This has become Oops All Dungeons. As soon as I find this key, big key, though, I am outie. That is a light world only feature. Let's go beat this game. I don't think it's gonna be sub 3. But man, some of those, the amount of backtracking I had to do this time around. What a way to start this back up. What am I doing? I'm not going that way this time. So my guess is that Gold Sword was probably further on in Swamp, or it could be in one of the upper chests, and I usually check a couple of the upper ones anyway, just because they're there, and... eh, you know, why not? Thank you. I would say the next couple of rooms here collectively make up the worst rooms in the game. I love this trick here. Boop, boop. They're all dead. Or I guess undead. I don't know. I don't know if wizrobes are considered undead or not. Okay, bungled that. That's okay. Are you kidding me? Either golden sword was in the big chest here, or it was further up in swamp. Oh, cool. If I'm, it might be a sub 3 after all. Patterns are not good. Oh. There we go. God dang it. Excuse me? All right. Cool, cool. Get him. That was definitely a thing. But that's how randomizers go. Sometimes they're really easy, and sometimes they make you go way out of the way to pick one thing up. So, thank you very much for watching, if you have been. I hope y'all enjoyed this. I do plan on doing more, so if you like them, cool. If not, there will be other stuff still. There will still be Fusion Rando, and I'm actually going to attempt a speedrun of Metroid Fusion here soon, so be on the lookout for that. But otherwise, I hope everybody has a great day, great evening, whatever time of day it might be, and I'll see you again next time. Thank you.